This is a sonometer. Here there is a copper wire of length 100 cm. These two knife edges, here the horseshoe magnet. This is step down transformer. Here we hang some weight from the pulley which produce tension on this copper wire. Understood?
Start.
Now we take some observation. The first observation, length of the wire. Which wire? This copper wire. That is 100 centimeter. The second observation, mass of the wire is equal to 0.55 gram. This observation we take directly. The third observation, mass per unit length, that is equal to 0.0055 gram per centimeter. That is, here the mass 0.55 gram divided by 100. So we get 0.0055 gram per centimeter. And the fourth observation, as we know that acceleration due to gravity g is equal to 980 centimeter per second square. Hello friends, now we move to observation table. So in observation table, the first column is serial number, the second one is total mass loaded with hanger, that is capital M gram, and this weight hanged, and this weight hanged here, that is 150 gram. This weight produces a tension on this copper wire. We calculate the tension is equal to the capital M into G. The capital M is 150 gram and the G is 980 centimeter per second square. It gives us 147,000. Now the third one, the length between two bridges, that is L centimeter. That reading we will get from the sonometer. So now AC we will start the AC supply. So AC current will flow through the sonometer wire. The magnetic field of horseshoe magnet will produce force on this current carrying wire. As we know that the direction of AC current changes with time, so the force on wire will also change its direction. Due to change in direction of force, the wire will be oscillate or vibrate. Now move away these two knife edges such that the maximum steady vibration will be produced, that is the stationary values. So now we move these edges apart from each other. Still the stationary waves become produced.
can see the value.
So now you can see the vibration. That is the stationary waves. Now you calculate.
Stop.
Now you take a distance between these two knife edges. Take this reading from scale here and from this reading from scale here. Now take the difference of these two reading. It gives you the length between two bridges L centimeter. Suppose that is, we calculate from here, it is 51 centimeter. Fourth one is square root of T. Which T? That is the tension in wire. T is equal to M into G. So we take a square root of 147,000. That is equal to 383.40.
Stop.
Now the fifth column, that is under root T by L. We get that under root T is 383.40 and L, that is 100 centimeter.
Okay.
Sorry, in fifth column, that is under root T by L. So under root T as we get in the fourth column and L as we get in the third column. That is length between two bridges L centimeter. So in first reading, that is equal to 383.40 divided by 51, and that is equal to 7.51. Clear, friends? Now we calculate the frequency. The equation of the frequency F is equal to 1 over 2 root m multiplied by under root T by L. See, friends, this is the equation. We put the values of this. So is equal to 1 over 2 root m. Which m? This m, not this m. We will take M is equal to 0.0055 gram per centimeter and multiplied by under root T by L. So for first reading, we get under root T by L is 7.51. So we put this value here. So the simplification of this term is 6.75, multiplied it with 7.51. So we get the frequency F is equal to 50.69 hertz. Now from onwards reading, we increase the mass loaded with hanger. That is, in first reading the mass is 150 gram. Now we increase it by 50 gram. That is, we add. Now, see, the 50 gram of mass we added in this hanger. Now, we add this 50 gram of mass in this hanger. So, now the mass hanged in hanger is 200 gram. From this mass, the tension is created, that is 196,000. Now you know that how can we calculate the tension. The third column, the length between two bridges L centimeter, that also we calculate. from the sonometer, take a sound from the sonometer and calculate the frequency. Increasing mass in hanger, get the length from the sonometer and calculate the frequency. At last, you get the AC frequency with the help of sonometer. Okay, friends, thank you.